Welcome to Learn Computer Technology.
Learning outcomes. Understanding of Azure Kubernetes Service. Understanding of Kubernetes and pods. Understanding of YML. History of Azure Kubernetes Service. Access permissions of resources in different resource groups. Use of Azure Container Registry in Azure Kubernetes Service. Working experience with kubectl commands. What is Azure Kubernetes Service? Azure Kubernetes Service is a managed container orchestration service based on the open-source Kubernetes system, which is available on the Microsoft Azure public cloud. Kubernetes is the de facto open-source platform for container orchestration but typically requires a lot of overhead in cluster management. What is Azure Kubernetes Service used for? Azure Kubernetes Service is a robust and cost-effective container orchestration service that helps you to deploy and manage containerized applications in seconds where additional resources are assigned automatically without the headache of managing additional servers. What is Kubernetes as a service? Kubernetes as a service, KaaS, makes it possible to operate Kubernetes, the world's most popular container orchestrator, as a managed service. KaaS services are commonly provided in the public cloud, but some KaaS platforms can also be deployed on-premises. What is pod in Azure Kubernetes? Pods are the smallest deployable units of computing that you can create and manage in Kubernetes. A pod, as in a pod of whales or peapod, is a group of one or more containers, with shared storage and network resources, and a specification for how to run the containers. Steps to create Azure Kubernetes Services, AKS. Open Azure Cloud PowerShell Terminal. Let's create Azure Resource Group by name, kubegroup. Run the command. azgroup create --name kubegroup --location eastus. Let's understand the command. What to do, azgroup create. What will be name, kubegroup. Which location this resource will be created, location eastus. Let's create Azure Kubernetes Service in above resource with name, aksdemo. With one node and monitoring enabled. Run the command. azaks create --resource-group kubegroup-name aksdemo-node-count1 enabled-addons monitoring-generate-ssh-keys. Let's understand the command. What to do, azaks create. Where to create? Resource group kubegroup. What will be name? Name aksdemo. What will be number of nodes? Node count 1. What additional services to enable? Enabled add-ons monitoring. What credentials to generate? Generate SSH keys. This keys required to access AKS. It will run prerequisite by registering required resource provider for us such as Microsoft Operational Insights and Microsoft Container Services. Then it will run for some time and create the Azure Kubernetes Service infrastructure for us. Let's get the credentials to Azure Cloud PowerShell to interact with AKS form terminal. Run the command. azaks get --credentials-resource-group kubegroup-name aksdemo. Let's understand the command. What credential to get? Azaks get credentials. From which resource group? Resource group kubegroup. What is the object that we are taking credentials? Name aksdemo. Note. This credential is necessary to run kubectl commands in Azure Kubernetes master node. Master node of Azure Kubernetes Service is managed by Microsoft. Master is responsible of running all kubectl commands. It is consisted of control manager, API server, scheduler and etcd database. Master node function is complex in nature. That is the reason Microsoft is managing this node for automatic install and updates, also making this service simple for customers. Azure Kubernetes Service is a sub-version of Kubernetes open-source project honored by Cloud Native Computing Foundation, CNCF, invented at Google Labs. The core programming language in which Kubernetes is developed is Go language. Go is a statically typed, compiled programming language designed at Google by Robert Griesemer, Rob Pike, and Ken Thompson. Let's check the running pods by command. kubectl get pods. Note that kubectl is pre-installed by Microsoft for us in Azure Cloud PowerShell. Here no pod is running. Let's check the nodes by command. kubectl get nodes. It is showing one node as we have created by command during creation of AKS. Let's verify it in Azure portal. Azure resource group by name kubegroup is created. Click on it. On the overview page of resource group we found AKS resource by name aksdemo. Click on it. Again on overview page we find the details of aksdemo. To run applications in Kubernetes we need YML definition files. Let's upload app.yml to Azure Cloud PowerShell. The app.yml definition has pointer to fetch Docker image from Azure Container Registry for running in Kubernetes pods. In this deployment we are using previously created container registry. To know how to create container registry, visit the video container instance and container registry video. Let's upload services.yml to Azure Cloud PowerShell. Let's create IAM role so that AKS from resource group kubegroup can access Azure Container Registry on other resource group LearningDocker. This is also known as service principle as we read in previous videos. Let's create 6 environment variables. $AKS underscore resource underscore group equals kubegroup in double quotes. $AKS underscore resource underscore name equals AKS demo in double quotes. $ACR underscore resource underscore group equals LearningDocker in double quotes. $ACR underscore name equals LearnComputertech in double quotes. $client underscore ID equals $AZAKS show hyphen hyphen resource hyphen group $AKS underscore resource underscore group hyphen hyphen name $AKS underscore resource underscore name hyphen hyphen query identityProfile.kubeletidentity.clientid in double quotes hyphen hyphen output TSV. This command get ID of Azure Kubernetes services running. Here TSV means tab separated value. $ACR underscore ID equals $AZACR show hyphen hyphen name $ACR underscore name hyphen hyphen resource group $ACR underscore resource underscore group hyphen hyphen query ID in double quotes hyphen hyphen output TSV. This command get ID of Azure Container Registry containing our web app project Docker image. AZ role assignment create hyphen hyphen assignee dollar client underscore ID hyphen hyphen role ACR pull hyphen hyphen scope dollar ACR underscore ID. This command gives permission to Azure Kubernetes services to access Docker image stored in Azure Container Registry in Learning Docker Resource Group. Let's verify IAM role on Azure portal. Navigate to Resource Group, LearningDocker. On Overview, click Learn Computer Tech, Container Registry. Click Access Control, IAM. Then click Role Assignments. We found IAM role aksdemo, agent pool. This IAM role we have created now. Let's run command kubectl apply-fapp.yml to run application. Let's run command kubectl apply-fservices.yml to run services for above running application. Let's run command kubectl getService my-service-watch to get the details of running services of pod. We got the public IP of the running pod in which our application is running. Let's browse the application with public IP followed by port 5000 because our application is running in port 5000. Now our application is accessible. Some other commands are kubectl getPods, kubectl getServices myServices, kubectl API versions. Kubectl describe deployment. Kubectl delete services my services. Kubectl delete deployment app deployment. Caution. If you want to preserve your deployment, don't run kubectl delete commands. Kubectl get pods. Kubectl get nodes. Congratulations! By configuring just a few settings, we've deployed a publicly accessible application in Azure Kubernetes Service, AKS.
Hope you have learned and understand the topic. Please like, share, subscribe and express your views in comment for our motivation. Thanks for watching.